Greetings to you, Internet. It is I, once again, Sir Spicer, and we are here with yet another episode of, I almost said Darkest Dungeon, Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. So, we were kind of running around and doing some side quests. I was trying to find a fairy fountain, but I don't think I'm going to be able to do that yet. So I think what we're going to do now is we're going to try to find this other village that's over in this direction somewhere. Here somewhere. So that we can find out how we can, I guess, upgrade or add something to our Sheikah Slate. It has some ability that we do not yet possess, and it was suggested to us that we find out what that ability is. So we're going to start heading in that direction. Let's see, I got my horse around here somewhere. Is that too far away? Nope, it heard me. We'll get on our horse, Ed. Alright, Ed. Yaw. Yaw, Ed. There we go. Okay, so. Faster. No? Soothe the horse. Still doesn't quite trust us yet. Try to not get stuck on the pillars. There we go. Alright, and we're off. So we're gonna head towards that reddish light. See if we can find some stuff. Hold on. We have any arrows? Apparently we don't have any bows equipped. I guess we do. Boom. Nailed it. Last minute shot. Okay, we failed. So, let's see if we can get some bird meat. Drumsticks or something, maybe? Raw bird drumstick. Apparently when we killed it, we only got the legs. Alright. So we will head over in this type of direction. And see if we can find some kind of... I guess I forgot what the village is called already. Oop. Come on, horse. There we go. Listen to your master. Alright. Whoa, what is that? What are you? Shalaka? Oh, I think this is the thing we're supposed to give the seeds to. You, can you see me? Yes. Shalaza, Shalaka. It's been 100 years since anyone has been able to see me. I'm Hetsu, and I need your help. Those monsters over there stole my beloved maracas. Okay. I think they're still there on the other side of those rocks. I can't use my powers without them. So please, please get my maracas back from them. Sure. Not like I was doing anything important or world-saving. Let's see what we got as far as weapons go. Wrong button. There we go. Let's see. Let's use our broadsword. Alright, let's see what they got in here. What do I got as far as... let's use our bombs. Huh. Boom! Ow. Okay, we're a little hurt. Shove some food down our throat. We'll just eat this one. That'll be good enough. Whoa. Try to use our shield to give use here. that didn't work. Ooh, sweet dodge. Take that guy out. Alright, that wasn't too bad. Funneled them through the doorway. Got lots of Bokoblin parts. I think that'll be good. See what this treasure is. Probably the maracas, I'm guessing. And we got Hetsu's maracas. Alright. Jump down there. Thank you. Let's see. Can we... Can't pick these up. Let's just blow them up then, I guess. See if there's anything in them. Nothing. Alright, that wasn't too bad. Let's go give this guy's maracas back. Grab that horn. I mean, they weren't too tough. I'm sure he probably could have handled them. Yeah, pick up his rock. Wrong button. Wrong button. Wrong button. We'll just let that roll down. Can I not pick this up? Guess not. Alright. You sure are. You got it. Weird tree monster. But wait, there's something wrong with my maracas. The Korok seeds inside there are gone. How am I supposed to dance now? If I had just one Korok seed, I could sing, dance, and use my powers to help you. You see, I have the power of inventory expansion, so let me know if you find any Korok seeds. I have some. Love maracas, I never thought I'd target one. Just, but wait, sniff. I do have one. Alright. You got it. I just found it along the dusty trail. Oh, interesting. Weapon stash. Okay. That's a thing that happened. That's cool. Yes, I do. Let's go ahead and expand some of the other stuff. Let's just, we don't need to see your dance anymore. It's kind of a odd visualization there. I like how he actually says, da-na-na-na-na, in his dialogue. I'm going to go ahead and use the rest of these seeds, and then I'll catch up with you guys after I'm done with that. I won't make you sit through each one of these dances. Well, anyway, so he didn't have anything else to say, actually. I'm not sure if maybe I don't have enough seeds or something is going on. Yep. But he couldn't do any more inventory slots, so we just got the weapon slot and the bow slot out of that. Kind of need to come down here and flip a U-turn. Kind of neat that there's just, like, people walking around and stuff. I think we have to cross the bridge. Whoa, whoa, what's that over there? Stop. There's something blue and glowy happening on over here. I can tell you've trained your body well. I'd say you're... Sorry, I'm stuck in my throat. I'd say you're familiar with both sword and bow, correct? That's a good skill set. Why don't you join the Ygra clan? They were the ones who were with Ganondorf, weren't they? What? You don't know? Fine, I'll tell you. The Ygra clan. It's a powerful, brave group of warriors founded by Master Koga and dedicated to defeating the hero thought long dead. I will take your life. Okay, and we're fighting. Alright, we got this. What is that? Oh, shit. Alright, bring it. Bring it. so wily. There we go. Oh no, I don't want to throw my sword at him. I can't see him, but I know he's on the other side of the damn bushes. Alright. Boom! Alright. I don't mean to crouch. I keep hitting that button on accident. Mighty bananas. That, we'll just leave that at that. Hey, we got some money. I'll take it. Blue rupee. Red rupee. Apparently, these are just plants. What else? What's this? Vicious sickle. Okay. Cool. Glad I went and checked that out. So there are soldiers of Ganondorf disguising themselves as regular people walking around. Alright. Forward, Ed. We gotta loop around this area and then take a left so that we can head... From what I remember, what Impa said, to the other side, or to where, I wonder if the horse can jump. Because there was this shrine over here. It was actually next to the horse shrine that we couldn't get to. You guys remember that? It was like right over here. Let's just avoid that guy for now. It was like right over here. Yeah. I wonder if the horse can get through it. Oh, I'm so stupid. I already... God, how did I not remember this? So dumb. Those of you guys who probably saw the video were probably screaming at me. I can't believe I didn't remember this. It's easy. It's freaking... Not that. It's freaking ice. What happens if I put it right under it? That doesn't work. Yeah, you just make the freaking ice pillar and then you freaking jump. Just like that. God, I don't know why I didn't do that before. I'm not used to having these abilities, I guess. Alright, so we'll do this shrine. That'll give us our fourth orb. And then we'll be able to slap it into a ability point or something. I might do stamina. Just to see how much it actually increases. But I'm thinking we probably were going to focus just on health for now. Unless we really start feeling like we need more stamina. Interesting, you can use the wind to blow around the bombs. Because apparently they are very light. We look very reminiscent to like a Skyward Sword type Link. Ha! Dahama. Ha! Dahama! I found that funny. Maybe he's like, ha, like stop. Like he's like, ha! Dahama time. No? Okay. Oh, this is gonna be one of those trials. So I think if you push this and hit the down button, he just does it right underneath him. Good to know. Oh, what does this do? Aim outward. What does that mean? Wait, I'm hitting the button. Oh! Okay, that's pretty cool. Oh, shit. Need to do that a little higher. Let's just pretend that didn't happen. Can we cancel this one? I'll lift that one up like... Right there. I don't know if we can reach that, actually. Hold on. Let's put one right here. And then we'll put... No? Let's see. What if I really get it really close to this wall? Can I now put something over here? Maybe a little higher? Like that? See if that works. Yeah, there we go. Nailed it. Those look like some... Is that a bad dude? No. Huh. Okay, so we got two main paths that we can go here. I guess let's go this way first. That looks like a one-way trip. Maybe not yet. Let's go up here. There's some kind of ball thing falling through this area. Wow, this is going to reach really far. Okay, so that falls down there, so we need to stop it. Like that. And then we need to... What we need to do? We need to... Put one over here to stop it from lifting up. Like that. Boom, boom, no. Maybe make a little stair for it? Okay, that didn't really work. What if we put it right there? Boom. Boom. Oh, there we go. And then we need another one down here. Not sure how many of these we can have. Let's see if that teeters over there. There we go. Alright, we did it. I think. Did I do it? Yes, I did it. Also gotta be looking out for any extra chests. I didn't see anything up there. Sometimes there's good weapons and armor in these things. We found the bandana in one of these places. Okay. What do we got in here? Oh, this is it? I feel like I missed something. Let me take one gander around. I'll be right back if I don't find anything. Found it. I found the chest. It's over here. So we just go like this. And go like this. That should be able to get us to the chest. What do we got? I'll take it. Purple ruby. To buy more stuff. Money actually has more value, I think, in this Zelda, because you gotta actually buy equipment. Alright, let's go ahead and get our prize. You don't need to tell me all about it. It's fine. We'll just skip through it. Thank you very much. Give us the orb. Yay. That's our fourth one. That'll be some endurance for us. Once we get to a goddess statue, that is. There's one at Kakariko Village, but we'll get it later. It's not that important right now. Alright. We can increase our orc speed, which we already knew. Octo Balloon. We haven't seen any Octoroks yet. Okay. So that... takes care of that. And we need to go this way. So, if we take a look at our map real quick, we need to head over here. We could follow the road. I guess that makes sense. See if that leads us to a thing. I don't know. Another tower over there. some ruined guardians. None of them look active, which is good. Oh, except for that one. I got lots of arrows. That's not an arrow. I did not mean to throw my sword. Huh. Well, my shoulder bow broke. Hold on. Oh, we do not have lots of arrows, but we do have some fire arrows and some frost arrows. Aim! Ah! That is, well, now we're dead. I don't know if I like the motion aiming. It kind of... And this is the problem with motion controls in general. Like, they're very limiting. No one... Does it really immerse you more if you're playing a game, looking at the screen, and you have to go like this to aim? Like, I don't see how that adds intuitiveness to the game. That's just me. But it doesn't... I'm not a fan. I'm not a fan of motion aiming. It's like... I don't know. It's a little annoying. But now we're not throwing our sword. We can do horse combat. That's cool. I'm down with that. See if we can get over here. Nope, we missed. Man, they, horse has got not a lot of turning radius. Oh, wait. Equip the other bow. Jump on! Huh. Boom! Yeah, I don't know. I don't like that. Nope, we are, need a weapon. Let's grab our claymore. No, why are you I keep hitting in on the thumbstick. Shit. Nope. Okay, now we're in slow-mo. That's fine. Kill those guys. Kill this guy. Okay. Could have been worse. Grab some of their bits. What is that? What is that? I don't want that. Alright, we'll take the soldier shield. I guess we can't take any more items. That's fine. What else we got here? Got a horse. Oh, there's a dude over there. We don't have any arrows. I wonder if he would like if it would let me switch a fire arrow. Turns out he doesn't like it very much at all. Alright, let's see what this has got. A lot of dudes here. Maybe it'll be something good. Go ahead and open up this chest. Another opal. Okay, not bad. They were worth some rupees. And we don't know if selling those were a terrible idea. They probably was a terrible idea. I think we're good on food. We'll go ahead and eat this seared steak. There's a lot of stuff around here. Just stuff in general. There's lots of it. The horse does kind of jump over obstacles, which is nice. What is that musical noise? Like, what is that? Is that just music or what? I guess it's just music. Not any specific thing. Got something cool over here. Lots of these destroyed guardians. Let's see. Calm down there, buddy. Let's go this way. Gate opening is over there. Fort Hatrino. Okay. Fort Hotrono, whatever that means. Let's slow down a little bit. That's a beehive. Let's try hitting the actual hive this time. Got some iron shrooms. Anything else? I guess lighting the beehive on fire destroyed it. Probably should have just shot it with a normal arrow, which we don't have. So I guess we'll have to forego that for a second. Which is over here. Just a river. A little house over here. Let's try to avoid being mauled to death by bees. I guess it's being stung to death, not mauled to death, but close enough. Choo-choo! It's dead. Alright, let's go in here. There's a worn book. Of course we'll read it. A dark was lies in the cursed statue's eyes. Pierce its gaze to purge the seal from the shrine. Okay. So that's obviously a puzzle. I kind of want to light up the fireplace. Did that... Nope. Apparently that's not the best way to light a fireplace. So... Is that something out here, maybe? Do we see any eyeballs out here? No. I see a lot of freaking... just stuff. Looks like a broken wagon. There's a fox. Really wish I had regular arrows right now, but that's fine. Silent shroom. We'll take it. More other shrooms. We'll take it all. Got some pond animals. We'll take them. Grab them. Put them in our backpack. Okay. Where's our horse? Where are you, horse? There you are. Alright. Let's, keep going this way. I think the village is supposed to be around here somewhere. I don't really know. It'd be nice if we had, like, one of those towers to find. There's just so much stuff to explore. Lots of animals. We could be shooting for meat. I'm not going to worry about that so much right now. We need to get up high. So that I can kind of get my bearings here. Try to find one of those. Oh, there it is. There's a tower. Okay, so we need to get over there. Ah! Nope. Oh, slow down. Slow down. Slow down. Slow down. Why? It's just slow. Wow, killed the shit out of that guy. Man, these, broadswords don't, work so great. Hey, no fall. Jeez. Horse kicked the shit out of one of those moblins, though. What's this? We got ourselves a hoe. We're not gonna take it, though. We don't need it. Thanks for helping me there, what's your name? Joe 2. If you don't mind me being horses are awful tired of running. You can just dig spurs. Okay, that's great. Alright, we need to get over there. So we need to get to that tower. So, I'm going to make my way over to that tower, and if anything exciting happens, I will bring you guys back. Alright, we are back. We've reached the base-ish of the tower. There are some bad dudes along the way, but I found that works really great for these guys is just charging them and hitting them with a big sword. It does wonders. You do increase damage, I think, while you're on horseback. Makes sense. And the claymore actually works pretty good. So, we need to get over there. I think we're going to need to do some climbing, so we'll park our horse in this type of direction. Stop, please. Thank you. I guess we could have ridden it up, but whatever. A little bit of a walk won't hurt anything. Lots of thorns. Lots of thorns. Can I cut thorns? No. I might be able to burn them. Tino Tower. Yeah, there's no way in hell we're climbing this. How's that? Does that feel good in your hey, okay. There we go. Is it gonna light up the whole tower? Nice. Not quite the whole tower. But a fair chunk of it. Hopefully enough to get us a little higher. I don't know how far this runs up, but hopefully not all the way to the top. Although it does look like it's up there. I think we might have one or two more fire arrows. Probably shouldn't have used so many of them fighting bad dudes. Oof. Just barely. Well, we might be able to. We got one more fire arrow. Oh my god, the motion aiming. Alright, let's see if that does the trick. It looks like it's going to do it. Yeah. Okay. Let's just head straight up. I think we should be able to get to the top. Hopefully. Oh, you're so high up. It's going to be an awesome view. Nope, that's not what I wanted to do. I have one more arrow. That's a sword. That's not what I wanted to do. Damn it. Huh. Well. No. Those thorns look like they go all the way around. Oh wait, we might be able to get up right there. We need more stamina though. Drop down prematurely. Alright. The bandana will help here because it gives us faster climbing speed. It's not a whole lot faster, but it is something. Oh man, I don't think this is gonna do it. Don't really have a spot to put our head down. Might be able to make it. Oh wait. Yeah. Okay. So we'll sit down over here. And then we'll go straight up that way. Alright. That's good, because I thought I was gonna waste those fire arrows. Not being able to climb up the rest of the way. But it looks like we should be able to make it. With our trusty climbing bandana, which doesn't really make a whole lot of sense, but whatever. It looks good with our current setup. And this will allow us to see if this is actually the place we're supposed to be going to. Alright. Let's put our Sheikah Slate in here. Let's see what we got. Pretty good view. Alright. That allows us to quick travel. Scanning area. Shoot your hot info all over us. Right in the Sheikah Slate. There we go. Hopefully we'll be able to see if the village is here. looks like we've got not a lot. Let's see. Correct button. What do we got? We got a mountain. Hatino Beach, Hatino Bay, Ebony Mountain, more mountains, there's a coast. I don't think this was the place. Well, I'm confused. It took away our waypoints. Like, we don't have the frickin' quest anymore. Now we do. That's weird. That's the one we want. Let's see where that is. That's where we're at, right? Yeah. So, it's over here. Okay, well, I mean, we were heading in the right direction. Let's see if we can make our way. Oh, we can literally see the village from here. I wonder if I just go, if my horse will find his way back to the stable. That's just one way to find out. Because this just is the ultimate way to travel right here. I want to make it to the village. This also looks really fun, but also really stressful. Like, your lactic acid starts building up in your forearms, and you're still like 130 feet up in the air. That was weird. Little loading issue there. Like about right now, but we're about ready to let our grip go, and we are still way too high. Drop, drop, drop. Drop. There we go. Whoa, what's going on here? There's, like, people being attacked. Back off, man. Oh, they're like, what the hell? They're like, they're knocked out? That's a new, mechanic. Are you okay? Can I talk to you? What's your name? Nat. They never fight fair. They're always lurk and wait to ambush us. What a bunch of cowards. Seems like every time I go out hunting for hardy truffles, I'm taking my life in my hands. Okay. That's all the info you want to give me? Okay, so we know there's a shrine here somewhere. In that direction. That's the direction we need to go to anyways. But I guess while we're up here, might as well check for shrines. It's beeping like crazy, but it's telling me to go this way. Where? Is it like below us or something? I don't know. It doesn't matter. Let's just go and finish up this quest. We can always search for shrines later. I'm not sure how much of everything I'm going to show. Obviously, if you want to get all the details, you should go and get the game and play it yourself. It really is an awesome game. But a lot of some of the side quests I may not show. Some of the just running around buying stuff at shops and things like that. I may not show, but I'll try to show all the significant things, especially going to the main quests. And any significant developments that happen. I definitely want to keep those in. But yeah, if I show every little thing with this game, it'll take me 200 episodes to get through everything. It'd be like doing a full Let's Play of Skyrim or something. And going to every single cave and every single quest. There's just too much video to be had there. But we will definitely go up in this direction. That looks like something we can light on fire.
Oh.
Hello and good evening. The night wind is cold, eh? What are you up to? What's it look like? I'm keeping watch over the windmills. My devoted wife and I stand guard day and night. She's not here right now. I mean, it's more of a time-sharing sort of thing. My love for her is so powerful that she suggested we take shifts. That way it feels more special when we're together. Funny, that was going to be my question to you. What are you doing skulking around in the dead of night? I'm a thief. I'm a traveler. Are you now? Well, that's fine. You seem harmless enough. Okay. Whatever. Alright, should be up on this hill. Keep our eyes out for shrines. Okay. I don't think I should kill their livestock. Sounds like kind of a bad thing to do. They'll pay. Hey you, what's up? What do you want? Oh, don't act so clueless. Although, fine. You seem harmless enough. Forgive me. I've just been on edge with all these monsters running around. They come up from the Hatino Beach to steal my sheep. Someone doesn't... Let's just think about what the moblins are doing with the sheep. That's all I'm saying. I won't have any left. The sheep rustlers. Can I help you with it? Which monsters? The stupid ones who attack anything that moves. Last time they showed up, I gave them a taste of my pitchfork. But I had second thoughts about following them back to their camp at Hatino Beach. I was mad enough to spit, but maybe not mad enough to take on 7 monsters at once. Anything else you want to know? The beach? Southeast of the village? I mean, monster slaying quest sounds cool. We'll definitely do that at some point. But... it's just like any open-world game. It's, like, so easy to get sidetracked. Alright. We need to go... yeah, this is not the correct way to do it. This is the way we're gonna go. Because I don't feel like walking around this mountain. That's where we need to go, up there. So we just got a little more ways to walk. Shoot me more shrines. I bet you there's like one of those Kakrikos down there. I was talking with someone, a friend of mine. He's been in some of the Let's Plays as a character. He's also a game developer, but hold on. Tech Lab, meet the interns. He's also playing this game. He really enjoys it. But he was saying, like, I guess there might be something like close to a couple hundred Koroks. That's a lot. Enter at your own risk. Okay. Alright, you gotta risk it for the biscuit, right? Hatino Ancient Tech Lab. If the flame is blue, the furnace is hot. Do not touch. Okay, I don't see anything. Well, she's adorable. Good evening. This is the Hatino Ancient Tech Lab. Do you have some business with the director? I sure do. The director is in the back. A terribly busy person, that one. Please try to keep it brief. Are you the director?
Yeah.
Good evening. I imagine you've never seen so many books in one place. Pretty incredible, isn't it? We've gathered all of Hyrule's known literature to ancient civilizations here. As for the actual number of books, well... is that... that thing on your waist, is that a Sheikah? There's no mistaking it. That's a real Sheikah slate, isn't it? I've never actually seen one in person. If you could just show me the runes on it, I'd be most appreciative. Stasis, magnesis, yes, yes. The remote bomb and Krynosis. And what else? Let's see. So that's it for runes. But, strange. It doesn't seem like you have the basic runes. I don't understand why they're missing. There must be some reason. Ah, where are my manners? I nearly forgot to introduce myself. My name is Simon. You are? Link, right? Yeah. Lady Impa caught me up to speed. How? She's an old lady in a house like 300 miles away. You see, we were told a young man holding a Sheikah slate would appear, and you must do all you can to help him. He will be the hope that awakens from the slumber of restoration. His name will be Link. Oh dear, I forgot to tell you something very important. I'm senile. Doctor, listen. Miss Director. This is a real Sheikah slate. Director. So that's right. I haven't introduced our director. Miss Pura happens to be right over there. As the Hatino Ancient Tech Lab Director, Miss Pura is the world's foremost authority of ancient Hyrule culture. She just didn't want to talk to us. Okay, check it. I have the utmost respect for Miss Pura and all she's accomplished. I'm honored to be her assistant. On that note, Link, you see, the director may look like a young girl, but, well, maybe it's not my place to be telling you these things. You should talk to Miss Pura herself. All right, let's talk to her now. Okay. Hey, hey, are you surprised? The director in this laboratory is not Simon, it's me. Snappity snap. Anyway, Linky, do you remember any dreams from the time you were in the slumber restoration? And don't you look like you've changed a bit in the last 100 years, but something must have happened in all that time. Well, no matter, I'm just happy you're still in one piece. Linky, what's that look? You still don't remember me? Really? Well, I'm so shocked. I don't even know if I'll be able to recover from this. Even though 100 years ago, I took you to the Shrine of Resurrection after Calamity Ganon fatally wounded you, which usually means dead. Even though I was the one who put you safely into the Slumber Restoration, despite all that, you still don't remember me? Nope. As expected, after 100 years in the Slumber Restoration, subject has lost all memories. Noted. Oh, sorry, I have a bad habit of taking notes rather abruptly like that. It's a charming quirk, isn't it? Anywho, do you have any questions for me? Are you a child? How very rude. Or perhaps it's not rude at all. I suppose I'm actually a rather logical conclusion to jump to. The truth is, I look this way because of a failed experiment. Well, I say failed, but in some ways it was a success. I documented the full affair in my diary upstairs. But the whole thing is embarrassing, so I insist you refrain from reading it. Anyway, we're probably going to read it. Enough about that, back to the topic at hand. Here you are, after 100 years, here to defeat Calamity Ganon, who is growing in strength with every passing moment, and to rescue our beloved Princess Zelda, that is, if you've got the courage to try. Is that like a stab? Because I'm the hero of courage. And to help the one true hero, the one and only Pura, will restore the basic functions missing from your Sheikah slate. And what do you say to that? Do it. Alright then, first I need you to run an errand, of course. What's with that look on your face? You don't think I'd fix your Sheikah slate for free, do you? Actually, yeah, I'm gonna save the world. Like, you know, whatever errand you have can't be that important. Post-slumber of restoration, subject plagued by presumptuous tendencies, noted. Let me explain what this errand entails. You know the unit furnace on the wall just outside the laboratory? Could you please bring the blue flame from the ancient furnace in town? Oh, and also use it to light our furnace. The sweet little guidance stone will start working once you do that, allowing us to restore the missing runes. I wonder if young women these days still say things like sweet and little. Ah well, I suppose it doesn't matter anyway. What? Okay then, I'm counting on you for that blue flame. And we will go after the blue flame in the next episode. So, make sure you guys hit the thumbs up button if you're enjoying these videos. Subscribe if you haven't already. Leave comments on all the massive amount of stuff I'm missing, and I'll try to get to it eventually. And as always, I will see you guys in the next episode. Peace out.